Whoops. No! No! Come back! I can't even imagine how painful it would be to get shot in the hand like that. Especially where he got shot right in the thumb. That had to be painful. I heard gunfire. Huh. Okay, then. Must have been nothing. Definitely hearing gunfire. Where is that coming from? Like, who the crap is shooting? Maybe I'm just going crazy.
Excuse me, are you Seth?
Who are you?
I'm a friend of Mr. Wes Dickens. My name's Marston. John Marston.
Goodbye, John Marston. It's been a great pleasure.
I need your help, Seth. We need your help. Me and Mr. Wes Dickens.
Let me be frank for one second, partner. I hate people. It was people who got me in this mess in the first place.
What mess?
Look at me. Look. Scrambling around, look for maps, half insane. I ain't washed in 6 months. My hair falling out, my mind's going.
What happened?
What happened? My partner. He stole half my map. I never would have done that to him. Never. Look at me.
Who did this to you?
My partner. My boy, my man. Moses Moore. I don't have the facility to tell you what I would have done for that man. And what I would do to him now.
Why?
Because he stole half my goddamn map.
And what map's that then?
The map, partner. The map that tells me where it is.
Where what is, friend?
I ain't telling you that. I don't make me tell, partner. It's mine. It's mine. All mine.
Sure. And where's this Moses now?
He's at Benedict Point. The law got it for it, Zuni. Some people, they feel differently. Not Moses. Him and me are the same. The self-same.
Well, come on, Seth. Let's go see Moses, get you your map back. Then maybe you'll help me.
Let's go. Horses are over here.
This guy's gone crazy.
Faster.
How can you sink that low? Digging up graves and looting from the dead.
Ah, hypocrite. The whole damn lot of you. Are you saying it's better to steal from the living? They're corpses. They don't care none.
These people have been laid to rest.
You don't know nothing. I talked to them long after they've been forgotten by every other fellow. I tell them it's all right to be scared and alone. I embrace them when they're stinking and rotten.
I met some sick bastards in my time, Seth. But you, you're special.
Folk is cold and heartless all their lives. To me, they get warmer when they're actually cold and heartless. Surely that makes sense to even you.
Not exactly, it don't.
Are we really living anyway? Do you exist outside my mind? Maybe we're both having the same dream, and when we wake up, we'll die.
I certainly seem to be in some kind of nightmare.
Fly! Fly!
You don't even know yet, John.
Have you looked in the cave, Seth?
It's very dark.
What'd you say?
I didn't say nothing.
I just heard you say something.
You're a crazy man. You should get that head looked at.
Seth, I need someone who can get a wagon inside Fort Mercer. I was told you could help me, but I'm not sure you even know what day it is.
I don't. I can't even tell you what year it is.
I knew this was a waste of time.
So, you want to go after Bill Williamson, do you?
You know Bill?
Oh, yes. I met Williamson and Deke, all them boys. Sometimes they call me on when they get some special job needs doing. I got a reputation as a man who do things most other fellers won't.
Now, that I can believe.
I reckon you can get in there, no bother. Assuming you help me find this map, that is.
Kind of reminds me of Gollum. Like the way he was crouching and hiding behind the rock, and now he's talking to himself.
What's so important about this map?
Nothing much. Just unimaginable riches and such like. A spark of hope that lit a raging fire I can't put out.
I thought as much. Another treasure hunter losing everything in the search for nothing.
Oh, I lost it all, partner. My wife, my children, my business. Good riddance to them all. I don't eat, I don't sleep, I don't wash, and I don't care.
I know. I can smell you from here.
It used to be about the money, but now, I don't know who I am no more. I see myself, but it's like I'm looking at somebody else. Only it's me. You know?
Maybe it's time you moved on.
No way I can stop now. It's taking me over. There's no difference between night and day. All right, this is it. Let's stop here a moment and come up with a plan. As far as I know, Moses is being held in that shack. There's a couple of deputies keeping guard outside. Can you distract him so I can sneak in for a quick parlay with that son of a bitch?
I'm sure I could think of something.
I'm quite honorable. So I think I can do something.
Lead them away from the shack and out of sight. Somewhere out past that hill.
Okay. Oh no. No! Dang it. Why does this crap always happen to me? Ow. Yeah, guys.
Are you looking for trouble, mister?
Sorry about this. Oh, great, I got a bounty on me. Huh. Ho ho. Okay. I'm gonna call my own horse so that way when I show back up, they're like, that's my horse! Give it back! Hey guys, how's it going?
Good job getting rid of them clams. Now keep an eye out in case they come back.
Come here. I'm faster than you.
Who the hell are you?
No, no. Crap. He slowed down too.
Name your prize. We gotta get out of here. We'll split it between us, just me and you.
I don't know how he's been held on, but that's impressive.
You just wait till I get loose, mister. Moses, you son of a bitch. Where's my damn map? Damn you, Seth! Damn you, Seth! You've always been a twisted freak. I ain't telling you shit. Then I'm gonna cut you off piece by piece. Till you find your tongue.
Friend, this man's gone crazy in the sun. I suggest you take my advice and start talking.
Shut up, Marston! I want to cut into a bona fide man's flesh. Ain't never cut into a live one before. It's an odd fellow's rest. Get away from me once and for all. Ain't that a damn shame? I was starting to enjoy myself.
deputies went and put a bounty on your head. Best we clear it now. Don't need the law on our backs. I don't have no money, but I got me a pardon letter. Here, take it. You earned it for helping me with Moses. Come on! We can pay it off in the telegraph office. Hurry up! I need to go find that man!
Good thing I got like three of these things.
Howdy, friend.
I pressed the wrong button.
I'll see you soon.
Whatever. Now I have a third.
So, mister, thanks for your help.
Don't worry yourself. Thanks, Seth. Just help me when I come ask.
No problem, mister.
Yeah, sorry.
Ooh, Stranger Quest. Yep. Let's go.
Next piece. I've been sent out here to provide a little frontier joie de vivre for the ladies back east.
I don't understand a word you're saying, mister.
Yeah, my mom felt the same way. Now she wrote me out of her will, and there's no hope for any of us. Jimmy Saint, sir, at your disposal. But please don't dispose of me just yet.
What are you doing out here, Jimmy?
Capturing the spirit of the West for a monthly back east. Yeah, I'm sending them my oh so witty, oh so pertinent missives, and getting myself a little prize in the bargain. So it's action I'm after, and action I'm gonna find too. Wild men, cheap women, guns, that sort of thing.
Well, you have fun.
Fun? I'm gonna have the time of my life, Spork. I tell you, mister, the time of my little old life.
Okay, then. Yeah, I don't know where to find the next I Know You one, so... Fine with my own horse, thanks. Yeah, I don't know if the stranger, I guess. I don't know if he's just in areas that I'll eventually come across, or it's randomized, so. If I can't figure out where the next one is, I might just look it up. Because I'm intrigued. Hearing gunfire again, but I'm not seeing anything. Come Oh, you get a little weirded out. My honor is literally maxed out at this point. That's how good of a person I am. Even in a game where you're supposed to be an outlaw, you can seriously just be the best person ever and still do terrible things. Maybe that was a gunfire that I was hearing, because I was so confused. I'm like, where is the gunfire coming from? I don't say anything!
Society is remarkably harsh on professional observers, but did you know that in ancient Egypt, it was an art form valued more highly than literature? I believe Seth comes from that school of thought.
Oh, very interesting. Look, you thought any more about our plan?
Ah, your plan, dear boy, your plan. I am merely the help, not mercifully the arbiter of wisdom.
What you are, dear boy, is the man whose life I've saved twice now. A man who sells lies and deceit to unwitting people. A man who, if he doesn't help me, I won't think twice about putting a bullet through his skull, feeding to the vultures myself.
You see, Mr. Marston, you have the exterior of a violent man, but the soul of an angel, and that is what I think I cherish most about you.
That's what I thought.
But before we can attend to your particular problems, we need some extra lubricant to oil the machinery of business. And this being America, that lubricant with which we concern ourselves is money.
Money? What are you talking about?
Oh, we need weapons. Armor plate for the wagon, extra hands, and I need some danger money.
So, let's sell some more of these cures.
Sell cures? Around here? Do you want to see me lynched? No. The sport of kings. Racing, my friend. The sport of kings. A noble activity without reproach. Exactly the kind of activity where a lying, cheating degenerate like myself can prosper. But come, let's finish the loading and we'll discuss it as we drive.
Now, sir, do yap, do preach.
If there's dialogue, I'm not skipping.
Seth is an interesting fellow, is he not?
wouldn't say interested, more deeply disturbed. I can see why you two get along.
I see the good in everybody, John. It's a flaw of mine. I have a soft spot for life's flotsam and jetsam.
Connection with them, more like. You and Seth have a lot in common. You both rob people, for one. Mind you, at least he waits until they're dead.
Oh, my dear boy. Nobody is more critical of drinkers than a drunk who's mended his ways.
What are you talking about?
Come on now, John. I've heard about you. You spent your life robbing people. It's a little inappropriate to be taking the moral high ground now.
I had the courtesy to put a gun in their face.
Whatever helps you sleep easily at night.
We stole from those who had too much. We tried to give to those who had too little.
A Robin Hood with spurs. Oh, romantic. You expect me to believe that poppycock? Maybe I'll have the good fortune to be able to leave my nefarious life behind one day and work on the government's dime.
Don't talk about things you don't understand.
Dear, oh dear, simmer down, my boy. You need to start appreciating your friends more. Folks around here don't see you as any different from Bill Williamson.
I didn't think I'd have to huckster snake oil and dig up the dead, that's all.
Take it from me, John. Collaboration is the key to success. I can help you. Seth can help you. It's business. Nothing more, nothing less. There's no need to make it quite so personal.
Suits me.
Of course, we're in the back.
Grabbers! Y'all know the rules! But for you newcomers, this here's a fair rate! Keep to your manners and let the faster cart pass! So now that's been said, y'all can get to running each other off the road like always!
Okay. Oh my God. I'm afraid I'm gonna overturn the carriage. I know how to move the cart backwards. Alright. Alright, we're fine. Oh, we're fine. Okay. This is so much harder than it looks. God dang it. The horse is really sensitive. Come here. Get out of here. God dang it! Son of a... I'm not gonna get first. Or maybe I can't. Go! The comeback of the century! That was such bullcrap, and I know it.
Sir, well done. Having you as a ringer has netted us a fine profit.
We seem to be wasting time, old fellow.
Oh, patience, my friend. The Trojan horse cannot run before it can walk, if you'll forgive the metaphor. Next, we need to procure some grand and overwhelming firepower. And for that, you need to contact an old friend of mine. Goes by the name of Irish.
Irish?
Yes, he's an interesting kind of fellow, and he usually can be found in Armadillo or some other town around here on some Bacchanalian revel or such.
Great. An alcoholic arms dealer.
What could be better?
Literally any other kind. I got $3. Fantastic.